Neon lights were flashing everywhere. As the boy stood there at the entrance to the arcade, he heard the familiar sounds of coins dropping and the beeps and buzzing noises, alerting everyone that there had been a winner. He loved going to the arcade. His parents took him every year on his birthday. His dad handed him a couple of coins and he made his way around, looking from one machine to another, wondering which one would be a winner. He watched as a young girl gave a cry of joy. The machine she was playing started pumping out hundreds of tickets that she would later exchange for a toy or a sweet. He went to the back of the room. He knew which machine he wanted to play first. The glass box stuffed full of soft toys was there in its usual place, the metal claw wobbling from left to right. He took out a coin and put it into the machine. He took hold of the controls and the claw came to life. He moved it across and waited for the perfect moment. As he pushed the button, the claw opened up and closed again. Grabbing hold of a white furry rabbit, he held his breath as the claw moved to the opening. But just as it was about to drop it, the rabbit fell out of its grasp. The boy gave a groan of disappointment. He picked up another coin and tried again. This time, the claw managed to get a good hold on a pink teddy bear. It moved it along slowly towards the hole. The claw opened and the teddy bear dropped into the hole. The boy gave a squeal of excitement. He opened the metal door to take out his teddy. But instead of a pink bear, a brown gorilla jumped out of the machine. It stood in front of the boy. "Hello," it said. "Welcome to SCP Exposed. Today we bring you the Euclid class object SCP-3092. But before I go on, don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you won't miss out on any more SCP stories. SCP-3092 is a black Thai Toys brand arcade claw machine measuring 1.8 meters tall. It is 0.8 meters wide and 0.9 meters deep, and weighs approximately 144 kilograms while unstocked. The machine's body and mechanical parts are all non-anomalous in nature, primarily composed of steel, plastic, and various electronics, all possessing wear and tear, consistent with multiple years of regular usage. When provided power and coins of valid United States currency, it may be operated as is standard for commercially available claw machines. Its anomalous properties only activate whenever the operator successfully picks up one or more plush toys with the claw and deposits them in its prize chute. At this point, the respective plush toys will immediately transform into instances of SCP-3092-A. These instances are cotton-stuffed felt plush gorillas, possessing no identifying tags or logos, sitting at roughly 0.3 meters tall and weighing 0.4 kilograms. These are sapient, communicative, and capable of sight, hearing, touch, and ambulation of all four limbs. Additionally, they possess notable manual dexterity, despite seeming to lack distinct digits and relative muscular structures. Outside of this, all instances are conventional plush toys lacking any biological components. SCP-3092-A instances are remarkably proficient in various activities related to guerrilla warfare, such as stealth, weapon improvisation, trap setting, and the maintenance and usage of a variety of small arms. They also appear to possess ideologies crudely resembling various real and fictitious guerrilla rebel groups. They are capable of developing and staging complex plans individually or as a group, and regularly attempt to breach containment with limited success. Thus far, all SCP-3092-A activity appears to have been intended only to annoy or inconvenience rather than cause legitimate damage to its targets. All weapons employed by the instances have been non-lethal in nature, causing only minor injuries. Any opportunities to cause severe damage to Foundation assets, such as through arson or the containment breach of other SCP objects, have been ignored in favor of more superficial attacks. Attempts to question the instances on the subject have failed, with all instances insisting that their attacks are massively damaging with many casualties. Implements and tactics frequently used include slingshot, small catapults, trip hazards, graffiti, glitter bombs, and buckets or canisters of various liquids placed atop partially open doors. All SCP-3092-A instances created by the machine have thus far possessed distinct personalities, beliefs, objectives, and identities. However, when an instance of the machine comes into physical contact with a non-anomalous plush toy, that plush toy will immediately be transformed into an identical instance of SCP-3092-A, with similar baseline personality, ideology, and behavioral patterns to the one which created it. The instances appear to be aware of this property and will attempt to make use of it in order to bolster their numbers. Many instances will, after being created, attempt to re-enter the machine in order to convert any applicable toys remaining inside. SCP-3092-A instances can be ripped, torn, or otherwise damaged with no greater difficulty than a conventional plush toy. Reactions to damage have been universally and melodramatically negative, with instances typically expressing hyperbolic pain over even superficial damage. Severe injuries, such as deep punctures or tears to the torso, detachment of limbs, or decapitation, will result in death, with instances falling to the ground and ceasing to move, typically after a long period of exaggerated expressions of pain. However, in cases less severe than complete incineration, instances appear to only be playing dead, as repeated disturbance of these corpses will result in them briefly returning to activity and requesting that this disturbance stop, as they are out of the game. Due to this information, as well as SCP-3092-A's lack of a nervous system, it is not currently believed that they actually feel pain. Repair of any damaged instances through conventional stitching, patching, and restuffing is typically sufficient to alleviate instances' expressed pain and death states, and is interpreted by them as medical attention. SCP-3092 is to be contained in an empty room equipped with a single compatible power outlet. It is not to be plugged in or stocked with toys unless actively being tested. Testing with it must be pre-approved by at least one Level 3 staff member, and at least one Foundation agent armed with a mock tranquilizer rifle must be present in order to subdue and contain resultant SCP-3092-A instances. The instances are to be contained individually in standard containment kennels, modified with two additional locks, at least one of which should be biometrically operated in order to prevent further containment breaches. They are to be provided amenities in exchange for compliant behavior, but none that could serve as tools or aids in an escape attempt. Should one or more of the instances successfully escape containment, a team of agents armed with mock tranquilizer rifles should sweep the site until they are recontained. And all personnel should be notified of the situation, be aware of their surroundings, and report any suspicious activity or SCP-3092-A attacks immediately. No plush toys are permitted within 200 meters of any SCP-3092-A instance outside of testing purposes. SCP-3092 was retrieved on the 5th of March 2020 from the family restaurant and arcade in Cheyenne, Wyoming, after animal control officers responded to a call. Their noted anomalous activity. When Foundation agents arrived at the scene, it was believed that 21 SCP-3092-A instances had been created through both SCP-3092 and their own duplication properties. The restaurant facilities had been considerably defaced. After killing several aggressive instances with small arms fire, the remaining instances surrendered to Foundation officials and were contained along with the machine after it was determined the source of anomalous activity. Civilians present were amnesticized, and a cover story of an escaped pet chimpanzee was distributed. On the 18th of March 2020, an instance initiated a containment breach and fled via an adjacent hallway. Agent Megan Cho, noticing this activity while standing guard outside SCP-3092's containment chamber, fired on the instance with the tranquilizer rifle she was armed with. Curiously, the subject appeared to pass out, falling to the ground and ceasing all activities besides occasional twitches and mock snoring. The subject was recontained without incident and awoke several hours later. Due to increased effectiveness and lowered risk over net launchers or firearms, it is recommended that Foundation again use tranquilizer weapons in the recontainment of SCP-3092-A instances in the future. After testing, it has been determined that any weapon firing feather-tipped pneumatic darts is sufficient to induce a sleep state in the instance, regardless of whether said dart is actually loaded with tranquilizers. Like the aforementioned death state, it is believed that this sleep state is performative on SCP-3092-A's part. To minimize the potential for collateral damage to Foundation personnel, mock tranquilizer rifles should be used in place of actual tranquilizers. On the 9th of May 2020, two instances simultaneously escaped containment and fled through the building's ventilation system before setting up a tripwire in the office of Dr. Martin Helmer, intending for him to trip, fall, and land face first on a pillow with a crude insult written on it. However, upon entering his office, Dr. Helmer tripped, fell, hit his shoulder against a bookshelf, and suffered a fractured collarbone, an injury much more severe than any induced by prior SCP-3092-A containment breaches. Upon discovering this, both instances immediately expressed remorse, informed other Foundation officials of the situation, and were compliant in recontainment. Investigation revealed later that several amenities within these instances' cells had been converted into gifts and apology cards intended for Dr. Helmer. Further breaches by SCP-3092-A instances have not been noted to employ trip hazards of any sort. Further investigation by Foundation personnel has revealed that the machine was in usage for 7 years prior to its anomalous properties surfacing. It has been noted that all SCP-3092-A instances have been fluent in English. However, they do not possess a regular sleep cycle. What do you think of that SCP case? Please leave your comments down below.